I'm a believer, okay? Anyway, the question is this. I always wonder in my head why a baby have a disease and die so early. What is the answer of God of this?
Why? Well, we can reverse that a little bit. Why does a baby have life and live?
Well, God gave the life.
Isn't it ultimately to get
by? Why have to be so short?
No, I'm walking you through it. I'm not trying to be smart. I'm walking you through it. It's to ultimately give God glory, right? Well, then, if God's sole purpose is to glorify himself and babies die, then there must be a purpose in that in which he's glorified. So the fact that you don't know that purpose, you need to know the God. And if you know the God and you trust the God of Scripture, then you will say, even though I don't understand, I know that you cannot sin, you cannot commit evil, you are holy, righteous, just, and true. So when that baby dies, there is a holy, just, righteous purpose. I don't know it. It's sad. It stinks. It hurts. But I trust that you know what you're doing. That's the best answer I can give.
Thanks.
God bless you. All right, I'm going to pass it off to Thomas here, and I'm going to stand behind him and do interpretive dance.
Have you studied Islam, the religion?
I have, okay. For many years.
Then you understand that the Quran is not the only source for Islamic theology.
Yes, there is hadith.
Okay.
Yes, there is
so
hadith.
Don't bring
but,
that
hold on. There is hadith, but hadith is the lowest level of information. First,
you
use...
Where'd you get that
from? Oh, because, where did I learn this? I think. Quran is always the first place of knowledge. And then after that, you use your logic. And then after logic, you use hadith, if you still cannot.
Where'd you get that from? Can you tell me where
I was taught that.
By
I was
who?
Taught that.
Is that
by
in the Quran or hadith?
By one of my religious mentors.
Okay, is that statement by your mentor towards you about Islam?
I don't know.
I haven't asked you. How can you say I don't know? Is that information in either the Quran or the hadith?
I don't know.
So
but
you're just taking your mentor's word for a doctrine?
No. I'm not just taking my mentor's word. It's logical. And so I...
But you're
going
to hold my feet to the fire to give you chapter and verse, but you don't do that with your mentor?
Also in the Quran, killing is justified in certain contexts. So in the stories of the war of Qadar and Badr, and as you mentioned, capital punishment, different types of things, killing is understandable, but murder is not condoned. There's one thing, I think it's in the Quran, that states, Killing one man is like killing all of mankind. And I think also in the Jewish religion.
Well, that's where Muhammad plagiarized. He played.
That's not right? Did I get wrong?
Okay.
Yeah, I know. We also have one. That's why
no, but here, here's the problem. That quote, ma'am.
It's not?
Okay, you don't want to talk to me.
I'm sorry?
Okay,
sorry.
Thank you. That verse that Muhammad plagiarized from the Mishnah, which is the Jewish commentaries on their own scriptures, was in the context of the Jews. Muhammad kept it in the context concerning Jews. So it's not a verse that you can take to say that Islam preaches the brotherhood of humanity and that if you take one life, it's as if you take all of life. Muhammad, soon after that verse, actually promoted the taking of life. So you have to read the whole context. That verse is not a universal application in the Quran. And a little bit after that verse, he actually does allow for the taking of life.
I'm sorry, is this the verse? This song, is it?
No, but I do have it in reference. Now,
can you please show it to me? Because I might be
okay,
receiving.
I will in one second. Another thing, the concept of who is worthy of death in the Quran and in Christianity are completely contradictory to one another. In Islamic theology, according to the Quran and the Sunnah, any non-Muslim is fair game concerning taking of life. Okay, that surah in Surah 5, in chapter 5, comes from the Mishnah, which is the Sanhedrin 4-5. That's the actual historical reference from where Muhammad got it. And that was a conversation between Cain and Abel that was taken from the Targum of Jerusalem.
Sure. But I'm not here to argue that the Quran and the Bible and the Torah are not related to one another.
Well, Muhammad was a plagiarist, so that's the only way they're related. He plagiarized the scriptures.
You're so... we're not accusing you of plagiarizing in any religious context.
Because I haven't plagiarized. Muhammad was a plagiarist.
So don't accuse our religion if we're not going to accuse yours. Okay?
Well, what if it's true?
What if Jesus plagiarized everything? I mean, it's the same. You can't accuse us of anything if we're not accusing you in return.
No, an accusation is I'm stating facts. I just gave you a reference. Hold on.
Please.
Do you have an academic background? You're educated, right?
Yes, I am.
Okay. I'm giving you a reference to the Mishnah, which is Jewish literature.
Okay.
Targum of Jerusalem, a specific reference concerning a revelation in the Quran, Surah 535, almost word for word. Muhammad took that record, put it in the Quran, and called it revelation. That is called plagiarism. If you have an academic background, you know what plagiarism is.
I do know what plagiarism is. I do know the definition of plagiarism.
So what's wrong with stating the facts?
That's so rude.
Just state the facts.
I just think it's really interesting.
How rude was it of Muhammad to plagiarize something and then call it his
own? According to Islam, is
that's
that,
not rude? Hold on. To plagiarize another work of literature?
Excuse me. In Islam... Islam, Judaism, and Christianity all share the same God.
No, they don't. So now you believe in the Son of God.
But
No. Welcome to the family of God. We have the same God, right? My God is triune and has a son. Mm. If we have the same God, you've now adopted the Son of God as your Lord.
Mm. Don't you believe in the Son, the Father, and the Holy Spirit?
You want me to convert to your religion, and then we have the same God. That's the only way.
I'm not trying to convert you.
But we have the same God, don't we?
Sir, please, can I finish my statement?
Well, do we or do we not have the same God?
We do have the same God.
So now you believe in the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit?
No, because those are three gods.
But that's my God. And if we have the same God, right, by default?
Would that not be God?
Trinity.
No.
But either way, listen to what you're saying. We have the same God. I define the God I follow. Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Well, that's not the one I have. Then do we really have the same God?
Well, in Islam, we don't recognize Jesus. Hold on. We don't recognize Jesus as the Son of God. We
that's
recognize
why
him as a
went
prophet.
To hell. The Father said, if you do not
so
have the
rude.
Son, you
why
don't have the
Why did you just say that my prophet went to hell?
How rude is it of Muhammad to deny my Lord? Why are you so okay with Muhammad's evils, but you want to condemn everyone else? Why
what
is that?
What are the evils?
He molested a little girl.
What?
He raped women.
Who did he rape and who did he molest?
He was a thief. He was a racist.
Oh my God.
He was
God.
A womanizer.
You're offending
me. Thumb it in a lost face that you don't have to wear your hijab.
Yes, I don't have to.
Okay, well,
in the Quran, it only says for a woman to dress modestly.
Which includes your hijab.
Hold on, that's open to interpretation, sir.
Whose interpretation? Mine or yours?
Mine.
Okay.
And any Muslim. It could be up to your interpretation, too.
So why are women beaten, imprisoned, and killed when they don't do it? Why don't the Muslim men leave them alone
because
to their own interpretation?
Because of whatever culture.
But it's interpretation, right?
Okay.
So why are the women beaten for having their interpretation?